Coming up, if you're in the middle of your cloud migration, dealing with legacy systems, or just want a better integration between Microsoft, third-party, and on-premises systems and services, we're going to take a look at how Logic Apps can help, including the latest updates such as our new SAP connector with bi-directional connectivity and the new integration service environment for direct, secure access to your virtual network resources. We're joined today by Derek Lee from the Logic Apps team at Microsoft. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
So we've covered Logic Apps on Microsoft Mechanics as really a core enabler for serverless compute in the past, but it's really a lot more than that.
It is. Logic App is a great enabler for serverless, but at its core, Logic App is about integration. Now, we live in an API-centric world. The connectivities API provide us is great, but writing code to talk to each and every single API isn't fun. With Logic App, we took care of which version of the API to call, how to authenticate, and how to pass data back and forth. So you as a developer can then focus on developing the core business logic and effortlessly integrate all the systems and services that your business runs on together. With Logic Apps, we provide almost 300 connectors out of box, connecting to systems and services within Azure, by Microsoft, and third parties on the cloud or on premises. Plus, that list grows all the time. Like you said, we just introduced a new SAP connector with bi-directional connectivity.
Now, I can imagine this would save a ton of time in terms of hooking everything up as a developer.
It does. With all the connectors that we ship out of box and with the rich flow control capabilities in Logic App, such as loops, conditions, exception handling, retry policies, we're talking about weeks or sometimes months of work down to days or even hours.
Right, and these flow capabilities make it more than just a connection or a point-to-point integration solution, right?
Right. With Logic App, we give you a general-purpose workflow engine on the cloud for all your integration needs. And what sets it apart is the Visual Designer. Now, in the Visual Designer, we allow you to easily build integrations, connecting all the system and services together, and make changes as your business needs evolve, all without having to write a single line of code. And in the designer, tokens are provided for you so you can easily reference output from the trigger or from a previous action throughout your workflow. And let me show you how that works.
Okay.
Here, I have a simple Logic App that monitors Twitter for whenever someone posts a tweet mentioning Logic App's IO, our Twitter handle. The first thing I want to do upon receiving a new tweet is to send that tweet to sentiment analysis and understand people's sentiment when writing such tweet. And is as simple as popping up the dynamic content picker and choose the original tweet text as a token to feed into the detect sentiment action. Now, once I have the score, the next thing I want to do is to push both the original tweet and the score that I just computed into a Power BI streaming data set so I can visualize the result. And you can see I built this integration in less than a minute with just a few clicks of a button and no code required.
This is really great because you don't need to define variables or things that you need in the past, basically, to bring all that state forward from all the previous steps.
That's right. And of course, you can extend the capabilities by leveraging the power of Azure. You can build an event-driven Logic App using Event Grid. You can connect to your data source, such as SQL Azure or Cosmos DB. Or you can add intelligence to your solution, like I did, by leveraging cognitive services. Or you can even bring in your own machine learning models, if you like. And this is especially great if we're talking about modernizing your legacy systems.
So do I use Logic Apps then for lighter tasks, or is this something that I can also use with business critical or kind of larger tasks as well?
Logic App is created for mission-critical workload, and by design, Logic App is highly robust, resilient, and performant. A lot of companies globally in healthcare, financial industries, governments, or even ourselves included, uses Logic App to process HR, business transactions, financial transactions on a daily basis. So let me explain to you how the resiliency works. Whenever Logic Apps start running, behind the scene, a background job is created for each and every single step in the workflow. And as each step executes, their states are being recorded and persisted in storage and report back to Logic App. The step can assume a number of different states, pending, running, or complete, and all these states are being logged. So now, even in the worst case scenario, let's say the data center goes dark, we can still guarantee the logic app start running before it happened will run to completion once the data center comes back online. And that is because of the data persistency, which allows us to reconstruct your logic app with all the necessary payload so that it can continue from right where it was left off.
Okay, so then Logic Apps takes care of your system integration, and with connectors and workflow, it's super resilient because it will resume those tasks right from where they left off. But can we see this all in action?
You bet. So let me first describe what we're going to build. We have an SAP system on-prem that we will receive sales orders from our e-commerce site for software purchases. Mm-hmm. Now, on the cloud, we also have a licensing server to generate keys, invoicing system that will create PDF invoices, and an email system that will deliver the key and invoice to our customers. Now, the goal is to connect them all together using Logic Apps and its connectors to fulfill the order once a purchase is made. We have a VNet that allows us to securely and bi-directionally connect SAP and Logic Apps together. So once a sales order is received, it will trigger a new Logic App instance. We'll then generate the software licensing key, generate an invoice, and then confirm the order via email to our customers. So let's see how to do that with Logic Apps. Here, I have a Logic App with SAP trigger already configured so that whenever a sales order comes in, a new Logic App instance will be triggered.
Okay.
Now, remember, my SAP system lives on-prem, yet with integration service environment and its VNet capabilities, I can easily connect to my SAP system from Logic Apps.
Right, so Logic Apps feel local to SAP.
Exactly. Now, the first thing I will do in my Logic App is to take that sales order, which comes from SAP as an XML format file, into JSON to allow me to easily work with the data within. After that, I will call into my software generation server to generate a new key. For it to generate me a key, the only information I have to provide is what item has been purchased. Mm-hmm. So I'm selecting purchased item from the dynamic content picker, and you see a token is again inserted to allow me to reference the value.
Okay.
Once I have the key, I will use the Microsoft Word connector to populate a sales invoice template. I will first specify where my invoice template is located, and it's called invoice.docx. Now, with this invoice, there are a few more information I have to provide in order for it to generate a sales template. Now, invoice number, so I will choose order number as the input, customer name, total cost, the item purchased, and eventually, customer's address. Once I have the invoice generated, I will upload that to SharePoint for archival purpose. Mm-hmm. So I will be using the create file action in SharePoint. I'll be uploading it to our team's SharePoint site. So I will select Logic Apps. We'll use the demo folder. The name of the file, let's just use the order number as the name and with a docx postfix. Mm-hmm. The file content will be what we just generated. So this is the invoice template filled with customers' information. Mm-hmm. Next, I will again use the Microsoft Word connector to convert that Word document into PDF format so we can send it via email. So let me select the Logic Apps SharePoint site, the demo folder, and I already know the name of the file, which again is a token allowing me to easily reference to it. And lastly, I will use SendGrid action to send email to customers with both the key and the sales invoice. The email will come from sales@shopcontoso.com. Subject will be, thank you for your order. We'll also add the order ID to it. In the email body, we'll say the key for item, purchased item, is the generated key. We'll send that email to the customer using the email address token. And lastly, we'll add the attachment. So the attachment content will be the PDF file, and the attachment name will be the order number.pdf. So now let me save the Logic App. And Jeremy, why don't you go ahead and make a purchase and we'll show you how this works.
Okay, sounds good. So I'm here in the e-commerce site here and I want to actually purchase Visual Studio Unobtainium. It's of course a fictitious name of a product. We'll go ahead and check out there. And now I can see that my information is already cached from previous orders. I'm going to do cache on delivery just to save some time in terms of entering credit card info. We'll hit complete order. And now the order presumably is being sent to you.
And now let me refresh my Logic App, runs, and you see a new Logic App instance just popped up based on the purchase you just placed.
All right, so let me look in email, and I just got this order confirmation here, so I'll click into it. And we'll see exactly my order as well as the key that I need. And if I click into the PDF, we'll even see all of that conversion and formatting that we just saw through the Logic App appear here in the PDF file.
Exactly. And let me click into the run and show you how the run history view works. So here, as a Logic App operator, I see how each and every single step in my Logic App executed, their state, how long it took, along with the input and output it takes during runtime execution.
So that was pretty cool. We actually connected up three different systems across on-premises and the cloud and all your workflow and got all that up and running just a couple of clicks. But in the real world, I'm guessing that there are a few more checks and balances in place before you start sending out orders.
Exactly. That was somewhat a simplified scenario just to show you how to use Logic App to build integrations. Mm-hmm. Now, in real world, you can easily add more logic to it depending on a particular business requirement. And in our case, we'll add some intelligence to it. So for that, we're going to add a custom machine learning model to check for possible fraudulent purchases and determine a course of action to take. The model looks for a few different things, such as if it's someone's first time purchase with a really large purchase amount, if the shipping and billing address does not match. And in Logic App, we'll decide on either to allow the purchase to be fulfilled or to put it on hold and trigger a manual review. So let me show you how to do that again from within the Logic App designer. So here I'm back to the Logic App that we just built to process the order. I will insert an action before I generate the key to call out to my machine learning model to detect whether it's fraudulent or not. For it to work, we'll feed the order data into it. After the action, I will use the condition action within Logic App to check for the returned value. So I will look for this property called isFraud. And we'll compare it to true. So if it is fraud, we want to put the order on hold. Mm-hmm. Now, to put the order on hold, I will call back into my SAP system. And remember, I mentioned we have a bi-directional connectivity with SAP. So not only are we triggering the Logic App based on a sales order appearing in SAP system, we're also sending some message back to SAP so we can put the order on hold. So we'll send a message to SAP. The SAP action will be a BAPI purchase order change.
Okay.
And for my input message, I will simply have to reference the purchase order that we care about. In this case, I will select the order number. So again, the token is inserted into this XML message that I'm constructing, allowing me to put the order on hold in SAP system. Once that is done, I will use the terminate action to stop the Logic App from proceeding forward. Mm-hmm. Therefore, we're not generating a new key. We're not sending that message to the customer. So again, let me save my Logic App. And I will go back to our shopping portal and make another purchase that will most likely be marked as fraudulent. So here I'm buying 100 copies of Windows Pi. I'm going to complete the order. And I will switch back to my Logic App. And if I hit refresh, we should see again a new instance popped up. And in this case, we can see that the check fraudulent order returned true. We sent the message back to SAP, putting the order on hold, and we terminated the Logic App. And you can see all the other actions has been skipped.
Really cool. So with this type of integration available, it's really going to help in terms of having hybrid models, or maybe you're just incrementally moving some of your on-premises systems to the cloud. Now, we really just scratched the surface here, but you can also bring your own logic and code into the Logic Apps flow as well, right?
Exactly. It is very easy for you to add additional step with code. And there's still a lot of areas that you can code to bring in more capabilities, which just freed you up from not having to focus on the plumbing. And you can also build custom connectors to connect to internal systems and allow a greater reusability within your own organization.
So this looks really great, but for the folks watching at home, how can they actually learn more and start using this for themselves?
Now, the best way for you to learn is to try it out yourself. So go to Azure portal just like I did and build your first Logic App today. We also have a tons of guidance available to help you get started, and you can check out the link shown.
And we're going to keep tracking the progress with Logic Apps on Microsoft Mechanics, and of course, keep watching our channel and subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time.